fifth theme teaching session of us. It's really on the topic of capillarity, and it is taken by the team by Sophie Moll, Archana, Merlin, Ria, and Anjima. I invite all the five members of the team to the screen. Now, team is going on the session.
कह दो तूफानों से आज रुखसरा मोड़ ले, आज होश उड़ाने की बारी हमारी है. गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अ वार्म वेलकम टू द फिफ्थ टीम टीचिंग सेशन. वी आर टीम मार्स. आई एम रिया जॉनसन.
आई एम अंजिमा जेनायर.
आई एम अर्चना स्टेवल.
आई एम मेरलिन अब्राहम.
आई एम सोफी मोड.
सो हाय फ्रेंड्स.
Hello.
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 Why you people are so lethargic today? Is there any issue?
A lot of online classes, sessions. We have been sitting in front of computer for quite a long time. We all are so exhausted with these. Look at our eyes.
Yes. I do agree with you, Ria teacher. If we teachers are not energetic, then what about our students? So we must be positive, right? Always and every time. So here, we the team, Mars, is ready with a new session of this particular lesson. And before getting into that, we will be having a short session to energize ourselves. And for that, I request everyone to stand up and set your own space. And here is half a minute for setting your space. And here goes time now. Ready, steady, and go and set. So, are you all set?
Yes.
Yes. So we, the team Mars, is going to have task freeze. Okay. So the first task is that move freeze. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
So what you actually need to do is that when I say move, you all need to move, and when I say freeze, you all need to freeze. Are you ready for the task?
Yes, Ashra teacher.
Yes, very good. So I'll be counting up and then we can start. So here comes the music for you. Can you hear?
Super, 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 mic.
Fiera con naturaleza, vamos a ver toda la vida.
Energize ourselves, right? So it's time to hydrate our body. So the best thing is what? Drinking water. So all of you, please drink some water. So here. Anjima teacher.
Yes, Anjima teacher.
Why you are pouring the water on the glass and then drinking?
Actually, when I usually drink water from the bottle, I usually spill it off the mouth, teacher.
It is better that you use a straw, Anjima teacher.
Yes, Riya teacher, I usually use straw to drink juice also.
Oh, so funny.
Anjima teacher, haven't you ever noticed the juice coming upward in a straw?
Yes, Marilyn teacher. I always observe that.
Okay. Does anybody know what kind of a force experience there? Whether it is an attractive force or a repulsive force?
It is of course the attractive force, teacher.
Okay. Now, we can move on to some more examples related to the attractive force of a liquid. So, just wait for the PPT. Okay. Yes. Here comes the first image. So here, what did you observe, Anjima teacher?
It is a sponge and a water, and I think the sponge is absorbing that water.
Exactly. So here is a sponge and a droplets of water. When we dip a sponge into a water, what will happen? Yes, definitely the sponge will absorb the water. You just keep it in your mind and just move on to the next image. Yes, here comes it. So what you observe here, Arsana teacher?
I see a paper which is being dipped in ink.
Yes, exactly. So here is the tissue paper and a blue liquid. So we can see here that the dipped portion of the tissue paper turns a blue color. And we can see that the tissue paper will absorb the liquid. And is there any magic there? Let's wait and see. And just move on to the next image. Yes. Are you familiar with this image? And did you seen in this picture, Ray teacher?
Yes, in earlier days, these feathers were used for writing manuscripts.
Yes, exactly. So, is it due to a property of a feather or ink? Feather or a liquid?
I think it should be the property of the feather.
Exactly. It is due to the property of a feather. Okay, Ray teacher. Let's move on to the next image. Yes, you are all familiar with this. And in this picture, what you can observe, Sophie teacher?
Here we can see a tree and its root is absorbing the water molecules, isn't it?
Yes, that's right. We know that the trees absorb water from the soil through their roots. But haven't you ever wondered how this water move to the leaves at very top of the trees? Is there anything suspicious there?
Yes, of course.
Okay.
There is some suspicious.
Yes, exactly. So, from all these examples, we have noticed that there is a particular phenomenon that is common. So, which will be further explained by our Anjima teacher. Let's move on to her.
Okay, Marlin teacher had made us clear about a lots of phenomena that happen around us. Now, we will be peeping into that particular phenomena. Now, you all observe these phenomena when water is rising up or the water is going down. Now, what is this? Now, the water when rises through something can be called as a particular phenomena or property of liquid that is called as capillarity. Now, here in this video, we are going to present you before that phenomena. Now, you can observe that small tube which is of a finite diameter and it is called a capillary tube. And when we are dipping this tube into the liquid, we can observe that the water rises up. Whereas in the second case, you observe the water is going down. This property of liquid to rise against the gravity is called as capillarity or capillary rise. Again, when you observe, when the tube is dipped into the second liquid, you have to observe it very carefully. That is, in the second liquid, the liquid goes down. And this is due to capillary depression. Now, this particular phenomenon we have come across is affected by many causes. What is the phenomena that affect capillarity?
Yes, there are some phenomena or factors that affect capillarity. One of them is surface tension. I think we all are familiar with the word surface tension, isn't it?
Yes, teacher.
Yes. Here, I am going to a demonstration. Please pin up my screen and we can see what baby I do. Okay. Here, in my left hand, there is a beaker of water. In my right hand, there is a razor blade. Can you see? Anjima teacher, can you see it?
Yes, teacher, it's clearly visible.
Yes, it is very clear. Okay, then I am going to my demonstration. Here, the beaker is all, this is a bowl, it is full of water. Now, it is a razor blade. I am going to put it in on the water. Then, please observe what it is being observe or what it is being doing. Okay. Now I am going to put it on my bowl. Now, this is our razor blade. I hold it this like and I am going to put it. Wait, it is due to have wind. I have some problem in my demonstration. Please be wait, it is some suspicious that our Merlin teacher tells that there are some suspicious in our daily life examples. Okay, this is also a daily life example. Here, there is so many much of wind problem. Please lick it. This is a blade. I am put it on the. Oh, again, I fall it. Okay. In Malayalam, that there is a. Recently, there is a talk that chilorku pattum chilorku pattilla, isn't it? I didn't occur this because due to this a lot of wind problems. So I think. Here I like to demonstrate that here when I put this blade this horizontally to the surface of the water, it will float on the water. Then I will show some examples later. This is due to a phenomenon called surface tension. Here, due to my mistake, not it is due to our nature problems. So here the blade will float on the water. Already because it is due to the some type of force of attractions of the surface of the molecules. Here the surface is water molecules. Water molecules hold together very closely or very tightly. Then the surface of the water acts as a elastic stretch membrane. So please note that the surface of water always acts as a elastic stretch membrane. Then the membrane, that type of membrane of the surface of the water molecule can hold some type of items that which may be density is greater than the water. The blade is, the density of the blade is greater than the water, but it will float on the water suffers already. Or always means this will be horizontally taken. If it is put this type, it will not float. If only you put this type, then it will float on the water. Okay. Yes, success. I get success in my experience. Please watch this. Okay, can you see my experience? Can you see it?
Yes, teacher.
What happened?
The blade is floating.
Yes, my blade is floating. Yeah. Okay. Now we become success in our experiment. Here we can say that there are so much of resistance or so much of problems we have to face, but we have to overcome it. Isn't it, Arjuna teacher?
Yes,
today we have to overcome it. Here, I am success in my experiment. I am very happy to explain my, and you got the idea about the superstition. Here, the water acts as a stretched elastic membrane, and the blade is float on this water. This property or this phenomena of liquid is known as superstition. Okay. The property of the liquid that acts as a stretched elastic membrane on the surface of it, then it is not a surface tension. Okay, is it clear, Riya teacher?
Yes.
Yes, I think it is clear. Yes, okay. Then we are, this is one of the property or this is one of the factors that are related to capillarity. Okay, then I think this is not only the factor, there are some more factors of the that will be depends on the capillarity. Isn't it, Ray teacher?
Yes, there are.
Yes.
Another factor is the force of attraction. And the force of attraction in the nature can be basically classified into two. Now we will see a video which explains this. Now you can see that a person is having mercury in his hand and he is going to pour it onto the dish. When he is pouring, you see that drop is getting coagulated with the, otherwise it is joining with the other droplets. That is one thing. And the next one is, you are seeing spherical droplets of water on a leaf. So these two examples stand for two different types of forces. The first one was mercury joining with other mercury drops, which are similar. So if A is one drop of mercury and A is another similar drop of mercury, they'll combine together. It is due to the force called cohesive force. And the second one, what you saw was on the leaf, you have droplets of water as spheres. It is because leaf is quite different from water. They are two different types of substances. Still, there is some sort of attraction between the leaf and the water. It is called adhesive force. So, if I have to define, the force of attraction between molecules of same type is called cohesive force, and the force of attraction between molecules of different substances are called adhesive force. These are the two basic forces that we see here.
So, okay, now we can see what is the relation between adhesive force and cohesive force with that of capillarity. Okay, so for that, we have a video here, which is being presented by Anjuma teacher, and we can just look upon it. Yes, what you can see, a straw is being dipped in a glass of water, and you can see that the water is rising. Yes, so the water has raised to the straw, and the forces which are marked now is the attractive forces existing between the water molecule, which is a cohesive force, whereas the attractive force exerted between the molecules of water and the walls of the straw is being termed as what? The adhesive forces. So this adhesive forces and cohesive forces are actually responsible for the capillary rise and capillary depression. Now, when do capillary rise happen and when do capillary depression occurs? For that, we have a picture with us. The picture is consisting of two test tubes, okay? In the first test tube, you can see that water H2O is being taken. And in the second test tube, you can see mercury. Okay, the symbol of mercury is Hg. Okay, and in the first test tube where the water is taken, here we can see a concave meniscus, whereas in the second test tube, we can see convex meniscus. Why do it happen? Okay, so for that answer, we have Anjuma teacher writing on the whiteboard clearly for us, and we can just look upon it. Yes, here comes the whiteboard explanations. So we have seen what two examples, right? So first one was water. Okay, so here water, it was taken in a test tube. And when I have taken the water, in order to know whether it is capillary rise or depression, I have put inside a capillary tube. And I have observed that the meniscus is concave. Okay, what is a meniscus? It is concave meniscus. Okay, so why there is a concave meniscus? Here, the adhesive force, which is A, is greater than the cohesive force C. That is, the attractive force between different molecules is greater than that of the cohesive force. Now coming to the second example, that is with the mercury, Hg. That also I have dipped a capillary tube in the test tube, and I have seen that the meniscus has become convex. Okay, that means there occurs a capillary depression. Why it happened? Why there occurred a capillary depression there? Because here, adhesive force is less than that of the cohesive force. That is the reason why in the first case, we have a capillary rise with a concave meniscus, and the second case, we have a capillary depression with convex meniscus. So I hope this is clear. Now for summing up, here we have Malin teacher with us.
Okay. Now it's time for recall, and let's check what all things we have learned. And first of all, we discussed about capillarity. So what is capillarity? Yes, it is a rise or depression of a liquid in a narrow tube or a minute hole. And later we discussed about two types of capillarities, that is capillary rise and capillary fall. And after that, we learned the factors affecting capillarity. They are surface tension, adhesive force, and cohesive force. And later we discussed about the relationship.
Now we are going to sum up our section. Then let's recap. Today we have studied or discussed about capillarity. We know that the rise of depression that caused by a liquid from or in a narrow tube. Or very small, thin, narrow tube. Okay, it is known as capillarity. Then they have division, capillary rise and capillary fall. Then we have discussed about the factors affecting capillarity. They are surface tension, adhesive force, and cohesive force. We know that adhesive force is the force of attraction of different molecules, and cohesive force is the force of attraction of same kind of molecules. Then we have studied about the relation of adhesive and cohesive force with capillarity. Okay, we all think that you got the topic, and now I welcome Sophie teacher for the follow-up for the activities, some kind of special activities. Okay, then we are going to an activity. It's a type of quiz. Okay, we are ready for that. Yes, teacher. Okay, first question is, which of the following accounts for an attractive force? Option A, adhesion. Option B, cohesion. Option C, both A and B. Option D, none of these. Anjuma teacher, can you answer it? Yes, I think we know that it's both A and B. That means addition and cohesion, isn't it? Yes, rightly. It is both A and B. Now, next question is, the attractive force existing between the different molecules is Option A, adhesive force. Option B, cohesive force. Option C, magnetic force. Option D, frictional force. Archana teacher, yes, the different molecules is adhesive force. Yes, absolutely right teacher, it is adhesive force. Our next question is the attractive force existing between same molecules is known as option A, adhesive force, option B, cohesive force, option C, frictional force, option D, mechanical force. Next I'm going to Merlin teacher. It's same molecules is cohesive force. Yes, absolutely right. Next we have gone to our next question. The phenomenon in which a liquid rises or falls in a narrow space is known as option A, capillarity, option B, surface tension, option C, viscosity, option D, buoyancy. Ready check. Absolutely, it is right, capillarity. Yes, it is the topic we have taught, isn't it? Then, the answer is capillarity. Our last and final question is, capillary rise occurs when option A, adhesion is greater than cohesion, option B, adhesion is less than cohesion, option C, adhesion is equal to cohesion, and option D, none of this. Anjima teacher, can you answer again for me? Yes, it is addition is greater than cohesion. Yes, of course, when the addition force is greater than cohesion force, then only capillary rise occurs. Okay, this is our activity, and next I am calling Anjuma teacher for giving you some exciting or some follow-up activities which makes you curiosity. Yes, we are going to discussing, or I am going to giving follow-up activities to you. That first question, please note out, okay? Please take your book and note it. How the diameter of the tubes affect capillarity? Once again, I repeat. How the diameter of the tubes affect capillarity? Second question. What is the reason behind the softness of cotton cloth? Once again, what is the reason behind the softness of cotton cloth? And the last question, demonstrate an activity based on capillarity and sent via WhatsApp. Demonstrate an activity based on capillarity and sent via WhatsApp. Okay. This is our last and final follow-up activities. Hope all you are enjoy our class, all get our idea about the capillarity. So we the mass signing of today's section. So we are coming in front of you with later another very exciting section. So thank you all of you. Thank you.